What's up, everybody? Welcome to a new English Beat. I'm Katia, and I've got a vocabulary lesson for you today. We're going to learn 10 C2 verbs that will help you sound more advanced. Are you ready to increase your vocabulary? If so, take a notebook and let's kick off. So the first verb on my list today is to dread. To dread. It means to be frightened and worried about something that will happen or might happen in the future. It's a more advanced synonym of to be frightened or afraid of something. After the verb to dread, we can use a noun or gerund. Let's look at three examples with to dread plus a noun. The first one, I'm dreading my upcoming exam. I'm dreading my upcoming exam. Guys, I hope you're not dreading your upcoming exams. The second example, she's dreading the idea of traveling alone. She's dreading the idea of traveling alone. And one more example, you shouldn't dread the future. You shouldn't dread the future. We can also use to dread plus gerund. It's very important not to use to, but ing. For example, Vicky dreads speaking in public. Vicky dreads speaking in public. One more example, I'm dreading telling him the bad news. I'm dreading telling him the bad news. And the last example here, I'm dreading going blank in the meeting. I'm dreading going blank in the meeting. Okay, now let's move on to our second verb, which is to wreck. To wreck. The letter W is silent here. To wreck. And we're going to look at two meanings. The first one is to destroy or badly damage something. For example, the explosion wrecked the entire building. The explosion wrecked the entire building. And the second meaning of the verb to wreck is to spoil something. For example, the coronavirus wrecked my trip to New York this year. The coronavirus wrecked my trip to New York this year. And one more example, getting stuck on one question for too long can wreck your reading exam. Getting stuck on one question for too long can wreck your reading exam. Let's continue. Our third verb is to neglect. To neglect. It also has two meanings. The first one is to fail to take care of somebody or something and give enough attention. And now let's look at three examples. The first one, we can't neglect the need for a healthy work-life balance. We can't neglect the need for a healthy work-life balance. One more example, we can't neglect our appearance when working from home. We can't neglect our appearance when working from home. And the second meaning of the verb to neglect is not to do something, often because you forget. For example, I neglected to answer his email. I neglected to answer his email. Let's move on to our fourth verb, which is to condemn. To condemn. The letter N is silent. To condemn. And it means to criticize something or somebody strongly, usually for moral reasons. And now let's look at three examples. The first one, the Prime Minister condemned the terrorist attack. The Prime Minister condemned the terrorist attack. The second example, we should condemn corruption and bribery. We should condemn corruption and bribery. And the last example, he was condemned for his lack of empathy. He was condemned for his lack of empathy. Okay, now let's move on to our fifth verb, which is to curb. To curb. It means to control or limit something that is not wanted, bad, or harmful. And now, three examples. The first one, you need to curb your excessive social media use. You need to curb your excessive social media use. The second example, he needs to curb his temper. He needs to curb his temper. And the last example, the government needs to curb inflation. The government needs to curb inflation. And before we continue, just a super quick reminder to subscribe to my channel and activate the bell so that you don't miss upcoming lessons. And now let's continue with our lesson. Our verb number 6 is to retain. To retain. It means to keep or continue to have something. And now a few examples. The first one, although globalization has brought many benefits, it's important to retain our local customs and traditions. Although globalization has brought many benefits, it's important to retain our local customs and traditions. The second example, let's call it a day. I can't retain any more information. Let's call it a day. I can't retain any more information. And the last example, the politician is capable of doing whatever it takes to retain his power. The politician is capable of doing whatever it takes to retain his power. Let's continue number 7, to spare no effort or to spare no expense. To spare no effort or to spare no expense. It means to use a lot of effort or expense to achieve something. After this verb, we can use a noun or infinitive. We can say to spare no effort to do something. And we can also use in doing something. So there are different options. And now let's look at three examples. The first one, you should spare no effort in passing the proficiency exam. You should spare no effort in passing the proficiency exam. The second example, no effort should be spared to fight against cyberbullying. No effort should be spared to fight against cyberbullying. And the last example, they spared no expense in their honeymoon. They spared no expense in their honeymoon. Let's continue. Our verb number 8 is to spur. To spur. It means to encourage somebody to do something or to try harder to achieve something. After the verb to spur, we need to use the preposition on. To spur somebody on something or to spur somebody on to do something. And now, three examples. The first one, the government should take urgent measures to spur on the virus-damaged economy. The government should take urgent measures to spur on the virus-damaged economy. The second example, my channel growth spurs me on to keep creating useful content. My channel growth spurs me on to keep creating useful content. And the last example, difficulties and obstacles can spur you on to succeed. Difficulties and obstacles can spur you on to succeed. Number 9, to bear fruit. To bear fruit. Remember that the verb to bear is irregular. It's to bear, bore, born. And it means to produce successful results. We can also say to be fruitful. So to bear fruit or to be fruitful. And now, three examples. The first one, his perseverance bore fruit and eventually his business took off. His perseverance bore fruit and eventually his business took off. The second example, unfortunately, negotiations didn't bear fruit. Unfortunately, negotiations didn't bear fruit. And the last example, keep going, your hard work will bear fruit and you pass the CPE exam. Keep going, your hard work will bear fruit and you'll pass the CPE exam. And last but not least, the verb to excel. To excel. The stress goes at the end. And it means to be very good at something. And we can use two prepositions after the verb to excel. To excel in something or to excel at something. And now let's look at three examples. The first one, you always excel in negotiating. You always excel in negotiating. The second example, Richard Madden excelled at the series Bodyguard. Richard Madden excelled at the series Bodyguard. Have you seen it? If not, it's a must see. I totally love this series. I have seen it twice. And the last example, cooking isn't your strong suit, but you excelled this time. Cooking isn't your strong suit, but you excelled this time. So guys, that's it for today. I hope you found this lesson useful and it helped you increase and expand your vocabulary. If you want to learn more advanced verbs, don't forget to check out the first edition right here. And it means a lot to me if you like this lesson, share it with your friends and subscribe to my channel. And also don't forget to connect with me on Instagram. With that being said, thanks for watching and see you next week. Ciao for now!